I'm with Regional Councilor Paul Vicente, who was just elected for Regional Councilor seats 1 and 5. Paul, first of all, congratulations. 35,000 people and what, 5,000 doors?
Yeah, we wore out several pairs of shoes on this election, Michael.
It was a cool scenario where you got together with Rowena and you did the city councilor and the regional councilor. How effective was this?
Well, it worked out very well, and we got a very receptive ear at the door. You know, people are looking for teamwork at City Hall. They're tired of the same old politics as usual, and they want to see their councillors and their representatives working for them for a change. And so the idea of pairing up with Rowena felt natural. It was the right move, and we're very pleased that the people of the city of Brampton, and particularly those in Wards 1 and 5, were receptive to our message of working together, of teamwork, and of working together to do the good things for the city of Brampton, to make the right decisions for the people of the city. Well, it's been 3 weeks that we've been in dialogue one with one another, and we're very happy to be working together with the mayor, Patrick Brown. He has pulled everyone and engaged in conversation with everyone, and so that's a very positive sign. We're looking forward to working with Patrick Brown and with our other council team members to make sure that we're making good decisions, that we are reflecting the community. Patrick Brown, in his inaugural address, talked about the diversity and the variety of backgrounds that we have here in our council, two Portuguese, two Italian, the first black woman, the first Filipino woman, some long-standing pillars here in the community, specifically Doug Willens, whose father was the mayor of Brampton, and Jeff Bowman, who has been a lifelong resident and an entrepreneur here in the city, Martin Medeiros, who I'm very proud to be working with because he, like I, we're both of Portuguese descent, and of course Rowena Santos and Charmaine, both amazing women, powerful women who I believe are going to do a lot of good and be a force here in the city to engage and to invite people to make good decisions on behalf of the city. I know that Charmaine Williams has a lot of deep concerns about how the community will adapt and respond to the introduction of cannabis here in the community. We know that cannabis is here, it's legal. And like other items, alcohol, smoke, cigarettes, these are substances that are in the community, they're being sold, and they are controlled. And so we're looking to make sure that in January, when we are looking down a deadline to make a decision on behalf of all the residents of this city, that we're considering all of the facts. And so it will be important as we meet in the future at committee and at council to listen to all of the points and then make a measured decision that's on the best interest of all the residents of this city. And I think that Charmaine is going to be very vocal about her concerns, and that's exactly the kind of representative that we need. We need somebody who is going to be speaking for the people and is going to look out for their concerns. And so I think that she's doing the right thing by talking about it with residents now and engaging with them. Well, of course, hearing about the defunding announcement and the loss of $90 million, which would have gone to the capital construction costs of the university, was a huge blow for Brampton. And in those early hours of the announcement, there was a lot of confusion and disarray about what was the future of Ryerson. And so Rowena Santos and myself, we wanted to give a reason for stability, to let the people of this city know that there are other ways that we could move forward and make Ryerson come true. And so we're very pleased now, after having time since that decision was made, to have conversations with Ryerson. And President Leshemy, he is as positive as ever to bring Ryerson to the city. And so we are hearkened by that, and we're very pleased that he is still committed. He has a toehold in Brampton. Classes are going to begin by Ryerson here this spring. And so these are all positive developments that speak to us that Ryerson is here to stay. And so we want to work with them and continue to partner with them to make Ryerson a campus, a center for cybersecurity, a center of innovation, a reality.
Is there one thing? I mean, you've knocked on 5,000 doors. I've seen your shoes. I know you've worn them down. I know this has been a passion. Is there one thing that you want to get accomplished that you wish to bring forward for the benefit of the city and or your ward?
In a word, economic developments. We want to make sure that we have jobs here in the city. You know, not having enough jobs in the city of Brampton causes a whole host problems and issues. Higher taxes, young people who are not working, traffic, which is becoming more and more difficult for the residents to deal with. All of these factors affect our quality of life. And so the people of this city spoke to us loud and clear at the door that they want Brampton to no longer be a city where we just come home to sleep. They want there to be jobs and opportunity here. And so as we begin to make decisions, we want to make sure that every decision that we make is done through the lens of how does it bring more jobs to the city. And so that's a tall order, because to bring 160,000 new jobs to the city of Brampton over the next 25, 30 years, that is a serious challenge, and we plan to confront it.
Paul Vicente, the brand new councillor for Regional 1 and 5. Thank you.